For videographers out there, I believe what we all want is high quality videos, and for us to achieve this, we need to use top-notch equipment. Yeah, I said top-notch. Anyway guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you haven't subscribed, hit that subscribe button down there and hit the notification button as well, so that you don't miss out on any content that I drop. So recently I ordered for a gimbal, a three-axis gimbal, and today it has been delivered, and that's what I want to take you through today. We shall be unboxing this gimbal right here. It is a three-axis gimbal, as you can see. It says for smartphones and action cameras. So let's go ahead and unbox this together. As you can see, it is all sealed, and it says it is a three-axis gimbal. As you can see, I think it is from China. Yeah, so if you have bias on China products, I don't know, but well, this is what I received. Let me go ahead and unbox this and see how we can go ahead and use it. Make sure that you dump this in a recycle bin. Remember, we are fighting environment pollution. Yeah, though that's not a recycle bin. All right, let's go ahead and unbox this. So I will are you ready? Ready, are you? All right, so this is what we have here. I won't let you see this for now. Let me take the manual out first. Then in the manual, we have quite some instructions that you have to follow. We have disclaimers, guidelines, safety operations, introduction, how to install a phone there, and quite a lot more. So well, you have the user manual here. For those who would like to read and know the details, I think it will take you something like 10 minutes and you'll be done with that. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for. Well then, ta-da! Yeah, this is it. We have this, an extension of the gimbal. Your gimbal will be mounted on this and it will be able to stand anywhere that you place it. Then we also have this. It's a USB cable that you will use to charge your gimbal. And then we have this, what we've all been waiting for, the actual gimbal. Yeah, well, in the user manual it says this weighs around 400 grams, so that's half a kilogram. The reason why it's called a three-axis gimbal is because it has three motors. One here, yeah, this one here, that's why it's able to rotate from this angle to this angle. That's one. Then we also have this one here, which enables it to rotate in this angle as well. Then we have another one down here, which enables the phone to rotate. Interesting, right? Yeah, that's why it's called a three-axis gimbal. So let me go ahead and mount this down here so that my gimbal can be able to stand on the table. Yeah guys, this is it. Just a few rights before we start, we have these buttons here. One is the on button, then we have this other button down here for, I think, capturing both images and starting recording and stop recording. Then we also have this one as well. I think it goes up, down, and in the middle as well. So we shall go ahead and see what they do. All right, and then we also have this joystick here. Pretty soft, it can go in all directions. It's a 360 joystick. So the next step that we are going on is to mount our phone on the gimbal. So if you can see down here, we have this docket here. Yeah, this docket here. So what we shall do is make sure that our phone fits in this docket here. So I will go ahead and mount it there, then push it so that it fits there, right? So when I let go of the phone, you see it is falling in one direction. So we have this knob here that will help us adjust. Make sure that every time you mount a phone here, you adjust this so that it always balances. If you don't do this, then your gimbal will be reducing on the lifespan of your gimbal. Yeah, I think it's now balancing. Just a little bit more. Just a little bit more. Anyway, this will take you time, but once you've mastered it, then alright, yeah, it's now balancing. It's now balancing. Even when I lift it, you can see it's all balancing perfectly. It's not going in one direction, it is balancing. So what we shall do is long press on this power button. The manual says that you long press this for 3 seconds. So if I press this, it's now on. And then once it's on, you will see it will light this screen here to show you that it is on. So guys, I'll go ahead and show you how to start recording using this gimbal. And later on, I'll show you some of the footage that I have been able to record using this gimbal. So let me show you something quick here on how you can use it. So open your phone. This is a security feature. All right, open your phone and go ahead and open your camera. Yeah, open your camera. And then something else is that it has a Bluetooth in it. The moment it's on, then the Bluetooth is also on. So go ahead and look for Bluetooth. Yeah, here it is. It says it has seen this gimbal. So I'll go ahead and connect and pair it. It's now paired, right? All right. So once it's on, all you have to do is just switch on your camera and then come here to video. So let me show you something interesting. Let us press this down here so that I can show you something pretty much interesting. So you see this joystick right here. This enables you move the phone in any direction that you want. So if I put this joystick towards the right, yeah, this is the right, it will automatically switch, giving me the shot towards the right. If I do this towards the left, then it will switch, go around and give me the shot towards the left. It gives me a 360 angle shot. The same applies when I do this up, it will go ahead and give me the shot up and actually rotate and see me, as you can see. Then if I do this, it will give me that shot the other way, a 360 angle. Guys, this is worth it, right? All right, so let me go ahead and switch this to where I want it. I want it to look at, I want it is my direction. Yeah, then the other thing is this is a stabilizer, meaning that I can actually shoot content while I am running and I won't get that shaky footage that might come out if I wasn't using a gimbal. The other thing that I want to show you, to tell you about, is I can shoot both landscape and portrait videos with this. So if I tilt this gimbal towards the left, it will automatically give me a landscape mode. So now I'll be able to shoot content for the reels, for those Instagram shorts and YouTube shorts. I'm able to shoot in a landscape mode, right? So, and then if I tilt this towards the right as well, you see it shoots in this angle as well, but I don't advise you to shoot your videos like this. So I'll just tilt it towards the left so that I can get this landscape mode, this portrait mode of shooting your videos. Alright, so guys, let me go ahead and show you how we can start recording. Since it's already connected to the phone, all you have to do is come here and hit on this button here. So when I hit on it, boom, it's recording. And no matter how I shake this, you see, let's let's take this plant here as our subject of focus. So no matter how much I shake, the gimbal will make sure that, you know, that this plant is still the subject that we are capturing. Then the other thing is that before you start shooting, make sure that you lock the focus and the exposure, because your videos won't look professional if the exposure and focus change automatically. So that's one thing that you have to work on. So to do that, go ahead and long press on this is our subject that we need. So go ahead and long press. Yeah, it has locked. You might not see it, but there is a padlock icon here showing that it has locked focus. So no matter how much I shake, this will stay in focus. This will stay in focus. If you watch till the end of this video, I appreciate you so much. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you will tag along and always catch my new videos. Remember, I drop one video every week, and if you guys keep showing me this love, I'll be dropping more and more videos. Big shout outs to Karim the Traveler for delivering this good piece. It is really a masterpiece. So you can go ahead and follow him. I've tagged his handle in the description. He sells all kinds of equipment for content creators. So go ahead and check him out. Otherwise, catch you in the next video.